YouTube, what the crap's going on? Heir of Carthage here, coming to you in full 1080p on Rome 2. So hopefully, for those of you looking for a little extra out of the videos, it will be there now. I'm enjoying the new monitor. Got really lucky and found one at kind of a special Walmart that's only here in Bentonville. It's kind of like an associate-only store. Picked it up for $78, which I thought was a heck of a bargain. It's a 22-inch LED, full 1080p Samsung monitor. Pretty excited. I guess Christmas came early for me. But in any case, let's continue the Carthage campaign, because where we left off was actually very interesting. And let's see. I'm going to actually switch this champion over into this army here. Get them some experience. This army here has got a lot of chevrons and it's already looking pretty darn good. Not to say that it couldn't be better. And that is the army, which is the Heirs of Phoenicia, which is a cool name. I do want to go siege Rome. I think I'm going to leave this army in Brundisium, and I'll take this army here. In fact, you know what? I haven't renamed my armies this whole time. We totally have to. So we've definitely got to change some of these names. So let's see. Pride of Mago. So these guys were defending. Well, you know what? How about let's give them names from here on out once they do something cool. And we'll give them a name accordingly. I have this army up here too, but I'm pretty sure I'm going to have to use this army to help fend off Stance of Forced March. We're going to have to get back over here to defend Ariminum once again. Ariminum's garrison forces, though, have proved to be quite heroic in and of themselves. But there are some more, however you say these guys' names, Ardiaei transports on the way. There's even more of them over here. I have no idea how these guys can even afford this, so I just killed two huge armies. They have that good size army, this one, and another one. Yet they only own one province. That is the magic of campaign finance. And no, I'm not talking about politics. So let's keep things going here. I do have a spy here, which I might as well just at least put into spy mode so they can do something useful. We're going to march this army against Tingus. They have no more moves on this turn, though. Carthage can be expanded, but I don't really have a whole lot of money at the moment. Let's go ahead and end the turn. I don't think there's a whole lot else I can do at this particular moment. And let's see if the Macedonians make any moves, like see if they put out to sea. Oh, the Romans want a piece of me up at Velothri, so they've come out against my garrison there. These troops are kind of damaged, but those are Arisakii units, which tend to be a little stronger. Oh, they got some Arisakii Extraordinarii there. I'm not sure I can win this fight, but I'm sure going to give it a shot. I've got 5 hoplite units. By the way, you might notice just a few subtle differences in the campaign map, and that is because I am actually running the patch 7 beta, and I do intend to try and get you some videos here very soon of the changes that patch 7 has right now. I mean, I'm definitely interested to show it to you, but of course this is a patch 7 beta. It's not the actual patch 7. It would probably be best if I wait and show you what it's like when it releases. But there are definitely some big changes coming. Things that are going to change the way the game plays in multiplayer. Plus, they've made some additional changes to help out with graphics optimization. Some campaign items. There's basically a list. If you go to the Rome, if you type Rome 2 wiki into Google, the first response will take you to the right page. You can just click on the patch notes, and it'll show you what it is that they're planning in this upcoming patch. There's a lot of great stuff coming. Is it going to make the game perfect in multiplayer? I mean, that depends on your definition of perfect, and I think that by anyone's definition, the answer is no. But I think that it's going to take the multiplayer in this game to the next level. I enjoy the multiplayer in this game right now, actually, but it's going to play out really fast the way it is, and that's mainly just because right now heavy infantry builds with elephants and stuff are just really strong. And so as far as from a competitive scene, it's not very entertaining. But I think these changes that are up and coming will at least freshen that up a bit. Let's get things started and see what the Romans decide to do. They're going to have reinforcements coming. Let me show you some of their troops. This ought to be fun. So they got some levies here, which not all that impressive, but here's some legionnaires. Very cool looking units, by the way, this game.
Enemy reinforcements.
Really like the way they represent some of these units. Auxiliary infantry, that's a cool unit as well. Legionnaires. veteran legionnaires. That's the general's unit. Awesome shields on those guys. Really neat. Some of the detail they do. And we'll see if the optimization really is running better. That was one of the things that... I say optimization. I don't really know what I'm talking about, but they basically said in the patch notes that they were going to optimize some of the graphics settings on Extreme to run better or with lower system resources. My computer seems to be taking this better right now. So we'll see, though. I mean, looks like I'm getting good frame rates, nice smooth and everything here, too, and I'm running it at a higher resolution than it previously was as well. So we'll see what happens. But it looks like the Romans are just going to come plunge right in here. So what I intend to do, obviously, is just phalanx up. My guys are in formation attack. I'm going to immediately take them. So formation attack in patch 7 beta is actually... and you'll see that it just says the unit will try and stay in formation. So why it's even there is pointless because it doesn't have any benefits. Maybe you can think of some benefit, but I'm going to take my guys out of it. And the reason being is what I've explained to you before. And if you all want some further explanation, go check out Zeript, his channel. I've linked to it before. I'll try and put a link to his channel in the video description. He explains it a little bit there, but when units are not in formation attack, they'll break formation and more of them will be attacking the enemy at once, which leads to more damage being dealt, which is the reason why Oathsworn... Oh, that was brutal. Those javelins coming in. Which is the reason why Oathsworn were always beating Praetorian Guard, even though Praetorian Guard had better stats. So... there's really no reason to use formation attack at this time, just unless you want your guys to look pretty while they die, because die they will. And these Roman units are definitely better in an attack than my Carthaginian units, and I'm getting a lot of reinforcements funneling in against me, so I'm going to reinforce with my own general here, just to pour some more troops here, and let's see, there's some veteran legionnaires coming that way too. I'd really like to come reinforce. That is a fight the Romans will probably win. Those veteran legionnaires are going to get in the way, though, if I come to outflank. These are Carthaginian hoplites, though. That's going to be a helpful unit. And it looks like you can't go into a hoplite wall anymore while you're engaged in combat. These guys can. Oh, that's because they're over here. Huh. Maybe that has something to do with formation attack. Well, if it does, I'd just still assume not be in formation, because I think my guys will do better out of formation. That was interesting. I know I had these guys. Yeah, okay, they are in hoplite formation still. Okay, good. You just can't go into it while they're in combat right now. That's fair enough. And maybe it was already that way. I don't remember. Or no, it wasn't with hoplites. It was that way with pikes, but not with hoplites. And as you can see here, the hoplites actually still do have a better charge than Roman infantry. And without formation attack, though, they would do better, except for the fact that Roman infantry doesn't have formation attack either. So, yeah, Roman infantry is pretty much going to pwn anything in a head-on fight. That's one advantage the Romans are going to have post-patch 7. Their infantry is going to be barbaric against anything besides pikes. So I do say that pikes will still be good, and they have made some adjustments with pikes. They act a lot better now. Though, they may still have a little ways to go, but when I was doing some quick testing with them, I thought the pikes were acting quite well, actually. And even though some Roman units, because of the way they've changed the formation on pikes a little bit, heavily armored units can actually kind of punch through the front of them and do a lot of damage. But it doesn't exactly always kill the pikes, but in some ways it kind of almost makes... You know, it's okay. You know, like, you don't want to see a pike unit just kill those guys, like, you know, 100 to nothing. Just because they're a pike formation, because then pikes would obviously be pretty overpowered. I've also noticed, too, that the bracing mechanics have changed, and Zerip talks about that as well. Mostly it affects with elephants and chariots, but it's definitely different and doesn't seem to be working quite the way it used to, so I'll have to reinvestigate that with Ace Blazer, of course, and put up some videos whenever the patch does release so that I can show you what it is like. But without the formation attack, you should actually expect to see hoplites and other spear units become much, much better versus cavalry, which will kind of make more of a rock-paper-scissor like we were used to in other Total War games. And you can see my guys here breaking formation, of course, and just chasing down these horsemen. Again, that happened a lot faster than we would have expected to have seen in a past patch. So I think there's some good changes here. Overall, good. There's definitely, I think, gonna... I mean, and obviously, it's still a beta, so we have no idea what CA is gonna actually release when they release it. They may clean it up some, they may adjust it. They probably are looking for feedback from stuff such as this, so... I think that it's pretty good for the most part. They may want to make a few adjustments. Another thing that happened in this patch is that javelins are considerably stronger, actually, too. Javelins have some armor-piercing attack now. Bows now have a little bit of armor-piercing attack, and all elite bows now come with heavy shot, which is going to... That's a wolf running down the street. Too bad he couldn't eat some of the Romans while he was at it. Yeah, so elite archers are all going to have heavy attack, or heavy shot now. Sorry, not heavy attack, heavy shot. So let's see, let's get all of these hoplites here. These guys are out of hoplite formation.
Spearmen ready for orders. At the double.
Yep, so sorry, I'm kind of like off pace for a minute because I was moving my guys. Oh, yeah, see, you've got some cav charging me here. I'm totally not braced. It's a good thing that they didn't have a real good run at me, or else they might have damaged me pretty badly there. I've noticed that melee cavalry does seem to be a little bit stronger versus infantry. In the next patch, that could just be some quick testing, though. I mean, again, I can't confirm all these things because it's still a beta. But I do think that overall there's going to be some good changes coming. And the thing that I like the most, and some people are still being... I mean, don't get me wrong, the release of this game was very rough. And I'm not trying to say that it was okay, but the release of the game was rough. However, for a long time I found this game to be very playable and very enjoyable. If you all don't agree with me, that's fine. I can't make you agree with me. But I find the game to be very playable. This is not good. My guys are starting to fall to these Roman troops, and I really need this hoplite unit. So let's get them back here, and let's take these citizens around and see if I can get an outflanking maneuver. And then I'll just throw them in over here, a few of them, just to kind of increase the numbers. There's only one decent unit here, which is the Sacae Equitae Extraordinari. Very cool unit. Love the shields and just the basic look of that unit in general. Some Sacae Equitae's Extraordinarii here as well, also a cool unit. But it's shot cav, don't expect to see it do all that well in a prolonged fight against hoplite units. In fact, my men appear to be winning this scenario in general. Okay, let's get these guys around here. We can chase down those war dogs. That's not good.
The men are wavering.
Ah, crap. All my units are wavering now, all my Libyan hoplites are getting beat down. Got this,
the men are wavering.
Got the citizen hoplite coming back, though I do not know that it's going to be enough to stem the tide here. And it may chain route because all of my other troops just did. Those war dogs released. Hopefully the war dogs will just go chasing my routing troops.
The men are wavering.
You know what? I shouldn't have thrown those guys into that fight, because if they route... Yeah, it's going to chain route my army now because of the power bar. Probably will, at least. Darn, I probably just threw away a winnable situation there. The enemy doesn't have a whole particular lot of troops left, but these Sacae Extraordinari are going to be a bit of a challenge. And I have to get back on the town square here relatively quickly. I'll see if I can start by trying to kill the general in this horse unit. Let's see if we see him anywhere. Sure, which one's the general? It's definitely a lot harder to spot which one's the general. Okay, I'm gonna halt real quick and take the charge of this Extraordinari. There we go. And then after the charge, I'm gonna click an attack order. So you see that units with mass do have a little more punching power into infantry formations, which does cause them to be a little more effective. You'll definitely want to counter-click an attack order, though, as soon as it's over. And again, my guys aren't in formation, so they're breaking formation there and coming out and seeming to do a little more damage to the cav units. I'm pretty sure that's going to be the end of that Sacae Equitae. They just put trample on right there, which is strange. See, my guys weren't braced right there either, and a few of my guys got killed by that general on a charge. If I can kill this general, though, that should help help a little bit, but again, I don't think I have enough left to take care of business here. Especially with all the Roman skirmishers running around.
As you wish. An entire unit has perished.
I'm gonna go into hoplite formation here. Alright, so hopefully in hoplite formation I can hold off. I've only got 99 seconds though to take the town center back. Let's see how I'm doing against these extraordinary. Well, my guys aren't falling quickly, but neither are theirs. In fact, well, now my guys are dropping. Yeah, my guys just don't have the hitting power to punch through these extraordinary. They're going to do very well now that they've had that stuff turned off, or the formation attack turned off. I'd have to have more numbers to win that kind of fight. Of course, they were doing a use the whip thing, so now that they're going to be suffering the downsides of that, maybe. My guys are fairly tired, too. I'm not sure if I can punch these or not. I'm just not dropping their men quick enough. The attack on hoplites is relatively low, so I don't expect a whole lot better. Well, if I would have played that a little better, we could have won it, but it looks like the Romans are going to take back Velothri, albeit a Pyrrhic victory. They lost 909 men in the attempt. That's okay. I guess we gotta let them win one every now and then. And it's not like my men didn't go down fighting, because I got 189 kills with my general, 166. A lot of kills there, so the Romans barely pulled that off. Nice blood effects going on there, too. So a valiant defeat for my men. You saw some of my men getting a couple of chevrons there. Let's see if the Ardiaei attack. Not sure if they will or not. I need to try and get a treaty with the Seleucids. There's got to be some way I can buy those guys off. And it looks like they've just navally blockaded me. And you know what? The Romans' little short-lived, you know, run to Velothri there is going to be just that, short-lived. The Gaetuli, where are they attacking me? At Carthage? Are you kidding me? These guys really think that they can take Carthage. And why are they getting... Oh, really? Because they have a few spearmen, you think they have a good chance at taking my city that has the walls. Well, I'd like to see it, so here we go. These guys never had formation attack to begin with, so I know that they're not going to have any particular bonuses. Yeah, they did reduce the damage that boiling oil does, so we'll see how that goes. But I really don't think that these Gaetuli clowns have a single bit of a chance at taking Carthage from me. And I will definitely be ready to make the Romans pay for that little outburst at Velothri. Actually, it was really my mistake, but hey, I'll make them pay for my mistake anyway. I don't have any problem holding the Romans accountable for my mistakes. I'm going to land these two ships here. Carthage is a big city here. Very big. It's got several capture points as well. I'm going to go ahead and start moving my troops down. I should have done that before the battle started, but we'll see what's going to happen. See where the guy to the land. I'm landing these two ships here as I usually do, just because that means that there's only one more slot here where an enemy ship can land. So that'll prevent them from landing any sizable force behind me. My men dismounting the ship here. No glitches this time, even though it was kind of fun to watch. Nope, no one glitched out. Everybody managed to get off the boat. I'm going to take these guys off fire at will and just hide them back here behind these buildings. And let's see what the guy Tuli got sailing for me. I know they have a bunch of slingers, which probably won't be too effectual because we're talking about a close quarters fight on the streets. Slingers are a unit that's going to do better out in the open. So we'll just go into fast forward mode and see what the AI decides to do. I do have a tower right here, so if they do bring a ship up, there's a chance it could get caught on fire and sunk before they get too close. This tower is destroyed for some reason. Not sure why my towers are, like, randomly destroyed. Let's see what we got. So the Gaetuli are not looking like they want to land on this beach. This is as fast as it can be fast-forwarded, by the way. So I apologize if you're like, "Eh, this is boring just watching those morons sail." Yes, I agree. I agree. But I do have to wait on them to sail. It looks like... this boat full of tribal slingers is going to make its way towards the harbor. So we're going to have to make sure that we don't give them a target to shoot at, so we're just going to halt all of these guys where they're at. That way the slingers won't be able to be within range of any of my units. I said halt. Dingbats. Okay, I think they've all halted. Looks like the guy at Tuli are going to land just a couple of boats on this side. I gotta get pretty shredded up by my towers. I don't honestly know how the AI is favored to win this. Let's see. And these slingers are getting shot by my arrow towers. I can't show you what the level of fire damage is onto the boat either, because it won't let me see enemy units on this difficulty setting. And now that they have come down, I'll just simply run my hoplites up and trounce them.
Valhamon has blessed us!
I can't attack them till they're all off the boat, but that means that they can't attack me till they're all... Ooh, I can attack them now. Alright, so let's get some close-up views of these tribal slingers getting destroyed. Looks like they aren't even going to get a volley off, I don't think. They are going to start running immediately, but they're already under fire from the arrow tower. Ooh, that guy just took a flaming arrow. Brutal. And my hoplites have caught them. Hopefully that arrow tower doesn't shoot my own guys. I could see that happening. So that's going to be our first Gaiatuli casualties. Over here they landed a Numidian noble infantry, which is actually a decent unit. And then they also landed a mercenary Numidian cav, and it looks like they're trying to land these spearmen somewhere, but they're not quite sure where. And these guys look like they're going to try and go all the way over to this gate. For some reason, the AI doesn't always go for the closest gate. Not sure what the decision-making process is there. The slingers are still alive, which is probably because I left my men in formation attack. Again, I can't really recommend using formation attack at this point. Got another Numidian noble infantry here, so both of the generals must be in this noble infantry. A fairly tough spear infantry unit. Numidian spearmen are garbage. Expect anything from them. So I'm gonna kind of just leave two of those, and we'll run to defend this gate with these guys. Give each town watch, and I'll take these two cheaper hoplites. And it looks like these guys are going to try and run to this gate. And we'll run these guys up here. So I'll split my defense force, run to each gate. I thought I gave these guys an order to go here, but I guess I did not. There we go. Alright, all my men are moving. We should be able to fight off the Gaiatuli attack here, so let's fast forward again until they get to the walls. They should be up to the walls up here sooner. Those arrow towers are definitely going to be taking their toll, though. That unit's down to half strength. This Numidian noble infantry now under fire while it's running. Even if it doesn't kill a lot of them, it's going to chip away at their hit points. You can see those guys have good armor and big shields, so it'll make them a little more resistant to missile fire. In fact, to have not taken any casualties to those arrow towers is pretty impressive. So they must have changed that a little bit. Impressive maybe, but it won't save them. Let's see, over here it looks like they are trying to burn down the gates. Not doing so great at it though. It's nice of the Gaiatuli to sacrifice these men to Baalpachi, the god of peasant suffering. You can see this guy here, two flaming arrows in his arm, still alive somehow. You see that block up the shield? That's what I was trying to tell you about the missile. Oh gosh, brutal. Check out these guys go. The funny thing is it's not making me feel sorry for them. They really shouldn't have attacked me, and then they may have preserved their lives to die another day. Die, of course they will. Wow, look, flaming arrow in the arm. Some of these guys are real tough guys, huh? It's like, I got an arrow in my arm, it's no problem. I'm good, coach, keep me in the game. Oh, but the arrow in the spine there was a little more than he could take. Wow, this is horrendous, but also entertaining. So those tribal slingers are going to rout. Looks like they got a new Midian spearman there trying to burn down the gate. Let's see what's going on over here. Heir's having a good time with this 1080p. I really like watching the pain and suffering of my enemies in 1080p. I'm not like this in real life, by the way, people. This is, it's just a game. Heir's not really that morbid. So these noble infantry trying to burn down the gate. And again, nice big shield, so you can see why they're going to be a little more resistant, but definitely starting to get some kills now. But you also see some arrows bouncing off their shields from time to time and being blocked by their shields. Really looking pretty good. Okay, let's see if they've... Yeah, they've replaced that unit over here. These Numidian spearmen are under fire now and taking pretty heavy casualties. Numidian spearmen. There was a noble infantry over here as well. It's taking a few casualties to arrows as well. So if they get into this gate, my strategy is going to be pretty obvious. Just make sure none of these guys are in formation attack.
Airmen, awaiting orders.
I'm just gonna to hole up right here with hoplite phalanx and hold these guys at the gate. Shouldn't be hard for me to hold them, and then I can throw javelins over with my skirmishers and then hit from the flanks with my other infantry. So let's just throw these guys into a hoplite phalanx. Over here, let's see if they're going to even have enough men to break through the gate. They've only done 7% damage, no, 32% fire damage to the gate, and they're taking some pretty heavy casualties. They're down over 40 men, so maybe they've added hit points to the gates or made it harder to burn down the gates, but then again, these guys are only chucking a few torches at a time because the AI's got them at, like, a weird angle, so that might be part of their problem. Let's see if they're a whole lot more successful over here. Yeah, they've almost burned the gate down over here. But they do have two units throwing torches. Good to see the AI using two units, actually. They usually just use one, and it's really a problem for them. They've actually got three units hurling torches, so this is good to see the AI making slightly different attempts. That means that they've done some different programming, so I'm actually pretty glad to see that. You all might notice the attack on these javelins is much higher, as I told you, and then if you look at the missile damage, it actually does have 10 armor-piercing. Javelins are quite deadly now. Beware of them. They will definitely take care of heavy infantry, and light infantry like these can expect some horrible pain from a javelin unit. So I expect multiplayer is going to be interesting now, because to be quite honest, like, someone could basically just attempt to kill the cavalry of an opponent, and if they had a bunch of javelin men or archers left, and you couldn't catch them with your infantry, you'd be screwed. This is not like the old patches, where heavy infantry is just, like, nearly immune to missiles from the front. The punishing power of missiles is abundant in this patch, and you're going to have to learn to respect it. And you're gonna... Skirmishing's gonna become a much more vital part of multiplayer in this game, so being able to come and keep your cavalry alive and whittle down your opponent's skirmishers so that you don't just get picked apart by skirmishers. So let's come in and watch the effects of boiling oil and see what happens here. So boiling oil's been changed, and we'll see what happens. These guys are gonna be our test subjects here, these Numidian spearmen. Here they go through the gate, here comes the boiling oil. Yeah, I mean, it's not like a drenching wave of death anymore. Definitely looks like it's causing some damage, though.
Dead.
And the enemy general, just one of them at least, died because there's a couple armies. So, I mean, definitely still painful from the boiling oil, but not killing entire units. But yeah, definitely still looking effective, because you can see the big pile of dead Numidians here. So we're not going to say that it's been completely nerfed. Look at this guy, like, flailing around, just getting a shower of boiling oil. Deep-fried Numidians, anybody? It's the latest craze, little country gravy on top, and some cracked pepper, and, you know, you can't beat it. Country-fried Numidians. Anyway, those guys are going down. They're going down big time. You can see they're actually pulling up their javelin men, which would actually be a little bit threatening to me, except that they have them on flaming arrows, which takes their damage all the way down to only 8. So they can throw those javelins all day long, and it's going to do very little. Definitely not concerned about it. I'm going to start throwing my javelins at this Numidian noble infantry. So see, I've got my javelins on the regular variety here, and they will actually be pretty damaging to this Numidian noble infantry. I'm going to throw my guys a quick reload as well. So I get my guys throwing their javelins here into the Numidian noble infantry, and let's see if I'm getting any hits. Probably so, because I doubt my infantry is going to really kill these guys that fast. My guys aren't really throwing a lot of javelins, though. It's like they're trying to avoid firing at a certain angle or against my guys. I can't tell. Maybe they're trying to avoid friendly casualties. I don't know what the case is. But my guys are going to do just fine. There's just a whole bunch of slingers and crap over there. Let's see if they ever... No, they did not successfully burn the gate down here. This Numidian noble infantry died to the last man. Look at that. Routed, and then the last man gets shot in the back of the neck, through the face with a flaming arrow and two in his can. Oh, man, that's perfect. Poetic justice. That ought to hopefully teach the Gaiatuli to ever visit Carthage again. So that means that this side of the city is safe, so even if the Numidians break through, which I'm not convinced they will, I'll have reinforcements coming. In fact, they not only didn't break through, but are dying. And of course, here comes all their javelin men and other units. And it looks like their guys are trying to kind of like stand out the gate and use their missiles, so I think if I just back up a little bit, this will be perfect. And the enemy general gets killed. That was the one that was in the noble infantry over here. You'll notice the boiling oil's no longer coming down, and that's just because the Gaiatuli have come through and then lowered this flag here, which stops the gatehouse from pouring the boiling oil. I'm gonna try and mob these Numidian javelinmen, try and get you guys all kinds of close-ups too. I know sometimes I'm not so great at it. Check out all these slingers and javelinmen, not sure what to do. I think there's some regrouped spearmen coming in here as well. We'll just come and meet them. I would imagine we're going to see the morale of the Numidian forces start to falter here. Let's get these javelin men up here on the gatehouse and see if I can take some shots down into this mess of skirmishers and try and rout them faster. Take all these guys routing, getting shot at by an arrow tower. These guys are definitely taking orders from Patchy. Good grief, look at that. One right through his skull. Brutal. I guess Carthage shows no mercy. I do have my men headed up to the tower, but it looks like a few of these slingers ran through and caught them while they were trying to get through the door. It's not any big concern, really. We need to route these slingers anyway. Supposedly they've made a patch too to help try not to get your general killed on the first few volleys of like some missile fire. I was actually playing the Battle of the Teutoburg Forest before I got into the patch 7 beta, just to check out the new 1080 that I had going here with the new monitor. And it was hilarious because I start up the Battle of the Teutoburg Forest, you know, and go see the whole dramatic scene. Varus, give me back my legions! And all that kind of stuff, and it's like the very first part of it, you know, when the flaming balls of death come rolling down the hill. And it was just hilarious because right after that I charged Varus into these longbow hunters or something that were up on the hill. And then, like, I kid you not, like, the very first volley the longbow hunters loose kills one man in my general's unit, and it was Varus. It's so funny because it's like right when the battle starts, it's like, Varus has fallen! And, you know, it makes you fail the mission. I was like, oh, that's just quaint, you know, the AI killing you with the first arrow that comes down. But supposedly that's been patched in the patch 7 too. I haven't really obviously tested it. But we'll find out as my generals either live or die in this... In these campaigns. And of course, this campaign was actually started a long time ago, so any changes that can patch forward will be shown in this, but there's actually some changes that don't patch forward. So in my next campaign, you'll get to see the full effect of all the patches, but to be honest, this one's playing pretty good already. And it looks like the remainder of the Gaiatuli units have routed, so just as I predicted, no real victory for the Gaiatuli, and they've lost a good deal of their forces that were out to sea there that they probably should have been using to defend Tingis, since I'm about to come and raffle stomp it. So I'm definitely looking forward to that opportunity. Later, chumps! So, in any case, that is nice. Nice to see. So we need to come up with a name. Well, no, that was a garrison army. We don't get to name them. Yeah. Every time my armies do something here, we need to try and think of a cool name for him, like something to name him after. A noble death. Who died? Oh, Hamilcar Barca, right before we took Rome. Well, that's just sad. Let's see who we got. Some A, whatever his name is, Nape. So plus authority, plus one growth, plus one order. Plus one authority, cunning, and zeal. That would be helpful. Meganid, Hananid, Meganid. So no one in the dynasty that I want. We're going to go with the horse general because it's a little less upkeep. I haven't even looked at the political scene here in a while. Let us take a look at it. Looks like we're actually the most powerful dynasty right now. We can secure promotion, which never hurts. We can secure promotion here as well. Good. All right. That'll gain a little power for my dynasty. We need to put pressure on Rome. Looks like Magna Graecia is going to come completely under my control. And so we need to just... that army's on forced march. I gotta stop. We don't want them on forced march. I'm going to stop right here in the city and then get them out of forced march on the next turn, because the Romans could totally ambush me. And it would... it'd be bad, but I'm sure I could survive it. But whatever, I'll wait just to be safe. Let's see, I should have my better ships now. I do. I've got some catapult ships here. That'll make this navy considerably more powerful. So let's get ready and start sailing them towards some of these fleets that are camping out here south of Brutium. That fleet's still repairing and refitting. And I'm not sure what happened to the mass of Macedonian troops that was surrounding Apollonia. Let us hope. Let us hope that they haven't sailed for North Africa. It's quite possible. I have an army down here, though, and I could probably fight back quite a few Macedonians. It's not the best army ever. You could probably use some ballista, come to think of it. So let's recruit a couple of those and one more Carthaginian horse, and then that ought to be a pretty formidable army. So we do have something to defend North Africa, just in case the Macedonians try to go around me. I thought that they would have blockaded Ariminum, and if we stopped one army with the heroes of Ariminum, I don't see why we can't stop two. Let's take these guys out of forced march and come back here and take out the Romans at Velothri, and we'll let Ariminum defend itself. Leave that army in Brundisium. And that is going to be just about all we can do for this turn. Let's see if there's any forces that we need to upgrade. Yep, I have a spy. Let's see. Can't upgrade either of those. So what did I give him last time? Plus one authority. Let's try and give him a little bit of everything. Let's see if I got some antagonist zeal, cunning. And then I can upgrade this... or veteran here. Let's see. So what does this one do? Plus 10 to critical success. Plus 6 to single combat. Red and games edict manipulation. Plus 2 authority and the critical success would be nice. Let's try that. Okay, this army can still move, actually, so we do need to go raffle stomp Tingis. Except for the Carthago Nova's finally decided to take it out, so... it's no longer necessary for me to raffle stomp Tingis. Let's see if any of these provinces back here are struggling. Doesn't really look like it. This one probably will, and will probably continue to struggle. There's another Galassi rebel army up here. There's no way for me to convert this province to Punic culture, because it's like right up in the middle of Sesitani territory. So, I mean, even if it does revolt, I don't care. I'm just going to let it go, and the Sesitani will no doubt take it, and since they're allied with me will be fine, but while we're talking about this, let's see if we can get the Seleucids to agree to anything with this. Honestly. Let's try... no, truth, they don't want a trade agreement. What if I offer to join their war against Egypt? And this other stupid faction that I have no idea who they are. So, it says moderate at this point, and let's see if they'll sign like a non-aggression pact with me. No. No... so apparently these guys just really don't want a non-aggression pact. So non-aggression pact is low. Let's offer some money and see if that sweetens the deal. Still low. And let's see if they would then... Nope. What about a payment in the trade agreement? Nope. What about a payment? Non-aggression pact. And I'll join your war against these two clowns. No. These guys just do not want a non-aggression pact, as far as I can tell. Let's try a trade agreement. Anything I can do to try and get... No. Well, apparently they'll take my money and my help in the war, but they're not interested in anything else. So let's join their war against Egypt, because Egypt's just like some little crummy army in the middle of the desert. Really? You don't...
The omens for these such guys an attack are fearful and terrible indeed. We are not fools.
You're not fools, but you won't take my money or let me join wars, and you won't sign a non-aggression pact with me. That's interesting. Maybe just Egypt. Let's see if we can get a join war against Egypt. Okay, whatever. Looks like we're going to be at war with the Seleucids in no time. Have no idea why those guys, don't want to help me, other than the fact that there's, like, the forced cultural aversion, which is extremely annoying. I mean, negative 25, I know I complain about this every episode, but really, negative 25. Just a bit extreme, and you can see the results of it here, which means that no one will deal with you whatsoever, unless they feel forced to. We're going to have to go take a look around. Macedon is just moving there. No attacks. If the Seleucids attack me right now, that would be bad, and it means that I really got to push this war with the Romans and the Greeks. Because if the Seleucids aren't going to sign anything with me, it is honestly just a matter of time before those clowns attack me. And they are not going to be quite so easily put down, as I'm pretty sure they own a pretty good chunk of the Far East, especially if they've gone off and killed Egypt. Someone's spreading cultural propaganda, port settlement, increase in rank, admiral dies for causes. Let's see, Hananid Dynasty. Meganid Dynasty, Barkid Dynasty. I'll take the Barkid, even though he doesn't have the best traits. Let's see, so there's a Athenian agent down here that's causing me issues. Let's see if my agent can take her out. Have a pretty good chance of slaughter here. Let's try that. Noble death. I don't know why I replayed that again, but I did assassinate the enemy. There shouldn't have been any additional noble deaths. Let's see, so this one gives me even more to campaign map movement range. That would be handy since this army may have to cover large amounts of ground. Carthage can be expanded, which is exciting. And I'll put a well there. Be awesome. Look, Carthage's getting bigger. That's sweet. I think one more slot and it'll be full size. Here's those Macedonian armies, or at least some of them. Don't see any of them down here, which is good. And we ought to be able to take this army out of a forced march and push into Roman territory from this direction. And the Ardiaei have sieged Ariminum with that crummy remnants of the fleet that I destroyed earlier with the garrison forces. We're going to retake Velothri here. We can just auto-resolve that. Dead. Right, so back in control of Velothri, and the Romans have managed to already build two temples, which is impressive. I'll just get rid of those. Alright, this army here needs to die. I don't want them behind my lines causing any issue.
In Baal Hamu's name.
Just auto-resolve them out as well. Alright, good to go. See if we can put these guys into a forced march back into the city. There we go. Put that spy into that mode. Okay, some of you have been saying you want me to recruit mercenaries. When I have some money, I will. They do cost a great deal, and they are fun to recruit, and yes, it does add to your forces. It's definitely good, but I mean, they are very expensive. So it's something that I'm aware of. I don't know if you all are aware of it, but it is indeed very expensive to recruit mercenaries. I'm going to take this army back to Carthage. The Sesitani aren't really helping me against this Galaci army, which is not good. Well, I mean, they're sitting here right next to my port, so if those Galaci try and take me over, it won't work. there's just going to be constant rebellions there, but I don't care. As long as the Gwaisi are sitting around, it'll... Or as long as the Sesitani are sitting around, it'll make it difficult for the Gwaisi. Looks like we need to upgrade Sacred Company here. Let's see, can't upgrade that. Let's go into Inexorable Conquerors, which gives me even more weapon damage and melee attack. We can upgrade this army here, the Heirs to Phoenicia. Let's see. I can't upgrade any of those, which is... They have no skill points. Oh, it's my general. And we get to pick a household retainer as well. That one is Will Overguard from CA. That's cool. Plus 5 melee attack skill for all infantry. I like this. And we'll go with Commander. Get things started here. I believe that's all I can upgrade, so let's end the turn. The next turn, we should be able to hit Neapolis and maybe on to Rome all in the same turn. It looks like the Syracusans and the Macedonians won a big fight, and the Ardiaei, or however you say them, are coming back at me with another big army of skirmishers that are supposed to win, and it looks like the heroes of Ariminum are back, folks. You thought that maybe they were only a one-time performance, but that is not true. Heroic once, and heroic once again. They may just be a garrison army. Maybe CA needs to make it to where I can name my garrison armies here because of their great deeds, because this will indeed be their second time. Indeed be their second time to perform great deeds. That's a lot of deeds. Kind of stupid of me to say that, but oh well. All right, let's start the battle. Get my guys unloaded there. Here's my valiant garrison troops. Any reinforcements? Valyrian Therio Spears is the general slave javelin men. Pretty sure they were all slave javelin men. So, this is going to be interesting. So in the last one that I played, javelin men were not, they didn't have the armor piercing capability. They most definitely do now, but they are still quite weak in a melee fight. If I can lure these guys into the city situation that I did last time, I will have a chance. Otherwise, I will not have a chance because these javelins can just simply unload on me. I'm also going to have to hope that the AI puts their javelins into flaming mode, because if they do, that will help me a great deal. It looks like these guys are going to go landing kind of all over the place, but we got a bunch of javelins landing over here. There's only a few spear units. Not that I'm particularly afraid of their spear units either. Here's some more Therio Spears here, which is not a very good spear unit. They're almost like a light hoplite unit. And these boats must be sailing clear over here. One is going to land close by. And these guys must be sailing clear around the cliffs to land over here. Well, let's just fast forward and see what the AI decides to do here. Let's see if they decide to form up and actually come into the city or what. And these troops are going to get behind me, but I could at least intercept those guys with, you know, even if it's just one spear unit in my mob, just to keep them busy. I don't see any Illyrian spear units there, so that flank shouldn't really be an immediate threat. Looks like the javelin men are going to be coming in from a few different angles. Actually, it looks like they're just kind of forming up right now, so we'll see what they're going to do. Looks like the others are going to land way out here. Maybe that's the closest place they can land, I'm not really sure. And that one's going to turn around and sail back somewhere else. And it looks like the AI is perfectly happy to just camp out right there. So what I'll do is just run a couple of hoplites around this flank. under fire over here. Crap. That's not good. They just killed a whole bunch of my militiamen. Crap. Yeah, you can see how effective those javelins are, because those guys killed about 50 of my men in no time, which is really a huge blunder on my part. Hopefully this battle's still winnable. I'll save the rest of my javelins here and just let my citizen finish those guys off. At least I think they can finish them off. Wow, those javelin men wrecked me. I can't tell what the AI is trying to do here. Their javelin men might turn around and win that fight. Good grief. These guys are going to have a whole bunch of kills. I've got more javelin men shooting at me up here, but fortunately they've got flaming missiles on. I'll use my own javelin men here to see if I can rack up some kills. I'm going to pull my infantry further back. And I'm actually going to pull one more of these hoplites back here and take this one out around the flank. If those javelin men survive, there won't be many of them left. This is bunching up all their javelins and really giving mine a whole lot more kills. So this is not necessarily a bad thing. Hopefully use up some of their javelins in the process. Okay, so their unit routed, and as did mine.
Our spears are yours. Javelin men! Find your targets! Stop! Spear me! Ready for order!
One of our units has used all its ammunition.
Javelin men!
I'm gonna throw my javelin men into melee over there. Just to pin these guys down, some slave javelin men in that vicinity. Let's go ahead and engage into melee here, and let's see if we can get... Oh, there's some Illyrian spears over there that's actually going to make it impossible for me to come around with just one hoplite unit there. So... I'm going to have to pull this unit back. I'm gonna make sure and push all the way forward, like just kind of try and run into these javelin men to keep them from throwing their javelins. Here comes that Illyrian spearman. There he goes, spears of action. I can kind of probably push this way now. And let's see, I've got the javelins behind me now. And I can use this. Use that hoplite to pin those guys down behind me. Attack those Thurio spears. My javelin men actually won that fight. Okay, these guys are running away, so I'm actually gonna just pull these hoplites back here.
Let's
see if we can catch these javelin men. Thurio spears are actually holding out a lot better than I'd like to see. But they used rapid advance, so they're probably going to be exhausted now, and maybe that'll help kill them faster. I don't want you throwing your javelins into my own men. Okay, so we've routed one unit, and I'll chase down the rest with those mob. These guys are getting just hammered with javelins, but fortunately, again, the AI is on flaming mode. It's just not really going to work to their favor. They're going to start hitting their own guys with the flaming javelins as well, which ought to help drop their morale. Fortunately, if those guys were not on flaming mode, they would be destroying me. Okay, looks like my hoplites are going to win the fight against those Thurio spears. Wow, this is going to end up being a little closer than I would have liked to have seen. These guys still have plenty of men left. These javelin men are lasting annoyingly long in melee, though. Seems like my guys really ought to be able to kill them faster than this, but then again, my attack's not very good.
What are your orders?
These are not like Carthaginian hoplites, so their attack's pretty low. Carthaginian hoplites actually have a pretty good attack, but the best I have is the citizen militia, and they're all pretty low. They're more similar to a Libyan hoplite. Okay, so it looks like I've chased off our skirmishers here. I'm just going to chase down those slave... Well, actually, there's no sense in chasing them. Just come back to the town center.
Hoplites!
These hoplites are fortunately, again, not taking many losses because of the flaming javelins. Taking it down from an armor piercing of 10 and an attack of 39 all the way down to 8 is definitely a reason enough not to use flaming javelins unless you're trying to run elephants amok. If you wanted to throw like one round of flaming javelins for the morale effect and then start peppering them with normal javelins, that would probably be a good idea, but what the AI is doing here isn't good. They are getting some flank shots on me now though, because my guys are turned around backwards, so those are going to be effective. Oh, these guys aren't shooting flaming javelins anymore, actually that's my problem. So it's quite possible my hoplites are about to die here because those javelins are so effective. Yeah, they're going to take them from the flank here. Those hoplites are goners. Fortunately, those Thurio spears are going to rout.
The men are wavering.
These guys are still set to skirmish. I should still have more than enough spears left to handle this. And they did get those hoplites over there, but these guys have got to be probably running low on ammo as well. And I've broken through their Thurio spears. Javelin on the town center routed. Alright, so we did win it. I bungled a few situations, but the heroes of Ariminum stand strong again against the Ardiaei. These guys really haven't learned their lesson yet, and kind of remind me of the Scipii Romans in my Rome 1 campaign, the Carthage campaign, where they just kept coming to die at Carolus. So there we go. And we're in a good position now to besiege Rome. Managed to save my province once again. Gadira this time. So this time the Gaetuli won a piece of Gadira with a tattered fleet. I don't feel like playing this, so I'm just gonna auto-resolve it. It looks like I'll get a fairly handy victory by just going into a protective stance. Those are just garrison fleets, by the way, so not really taking any losses there. And that'll help Carthago Nova as they attempt to take over Tingis. I don't know why the AI just sits around doing a whole bunch of raiding and everything rather than just getting the job done. And you can't attack the city while they have it in that type of position. I'm going to stop the adoption. I don't want them adopting my characters. They want me to recruit a dignitary, which I can probably do. But folks, I think I'm going to call it good for this episode. We are poised here to strike Neapolis, and on the very next turn at Rome itself. In fact, we can go ahead and just take Neapolis now. There's obviously no real force to stand against us here. Give this guy a good old stabbing. So only one Roman city remains, which is Rome itself. And we will see whether or not the Romans are able to defend their mother city. Something tells me that they will not be able to. Not against this army, at least. I'm not going to need a temple there. And I'm not going to need that particular building or this one. Don't want any of those minuses to public order, but I will rebuild that. Okay. So, yes, this is going to be quite bad for Rome. They do have some armies here making a run for Ariminum. Apparently, they want to take on the heroes of Ariminum. I'm pretty sure, I mean, this is going to be interesting. I can't stop these guys from going one way or the other, so I may once again just go ahead and put this one on force march and march them all the way back into the city. That way the Romans would have to turn around and march all the way back this way, and I don't think they can make it to Velothri, and then on the next turn I can just hit Roma. So I do believe, folks, that the very next episode of the Carthage campaign will be me undoing the Romans once and for all. And at that point, it looks like we're going to have a large Greek war on our hands, and the RDAI have apparently been issuing some type of reproduction edict, because even though I have dealt them one defeat after another, they have several large armies just ready to go at it. So, in any case, Heir of Carthage signing off for now. Hope you enjoyed it.